There's a new Quezzle coming. Thank you for joining us for an early look at Quezzle Space Adventures, a new mashup of quest and puzzle that's got a lot more game elements than the original.
Quezzle Space Adventures is a new mashup of puzzle and tabletop game from wooden puzzle company Unidragon. This is the second game in the Quezzle series, with the first being Quezzle Amazing CAPPADOCIA.
For more information on the original Quezzle, check out our Quezzle Amazing CAPPADOCIA review from back in February of 2022.
Links in the show notes or click up here. This new outer space themed Quezzle was successfully funded on both Indiegogo and Kickstarter and due to hit retail on September 15th, 2023. This game has you embark on a mission to four different regions of the galaxy, each owned by a different faction. You're going to start off by building your spaceships, then set out to explore the galaxy by building a 1,000-piece wooden jigsaw puzzle. From there, you're going to visit each faction and complete quests to unlock a clue from each. You're then going to use these clues to unlock a cryptex, which will lead you to the villain. What happens next? You're going to have to play through and find out.
Unlike the original Quezzle game, Quezzle Space Adventures is a single, standalone game which comes in a single, rather large, wooden box. Inside it, you will find the jigsaw puzzle pieces, a cryptex, a logbook that guides you through the game, and a picture of the completed puzzle with hints on the back. You will also come across a number of wooden punch boards for things like disc-shooting spaceships, dice, targets, and more.
Now, the quality of everything here, starting right from the box itself, is fantastic. The puzzle pieces are made of thick laser-cut wood and are painted with bright, clear graphics. The puzzle pieces fit together perfectly, though we did find the 3D ships were sometimes hard to assemble. You may want a rubber mallet on hand to get any stubborn bits to slot together. Now, a nice touch that's new in this version of Quezzle is that many of the items on the images are also textured and have an added slight three-dimensional element to them. Now, I have absolutely no complaints about the quality of this puzzle at all. Unidragon makes some of the best wooden puzzles in the world, and Quezzle, this new version, is of that same high quality that I've come to expect from them.
Well, enough about what's in the box. How do we use all of this stuff?
So Quezzle Space Adventures is much more than just a jigsaw puzzle. The tabletop game aspects of this experience start right with opening the box.
To even get Quezzle Space Adventures box open, you have to solve four word puzzles, then turn the rocket ship dials on the box lid to the proper letters.
Now, the next step, after you sift through all the cool bits and marvel at the uniquely shaped pieces, is to grab the logbook. This will lead you through the story, which has you complete a number of tasks, which start by building four 3D disc shooting spaceships.
Once you have your ships and have finished playing around shooting at the targets and each other with them, you move on to building the jigsaw puzzle.
So this features a 1,000-piece jigsaw puzzle that's going to take you some time to build. The overall image for the puzzle has a ton of tiny little detail, and the puzzle pieces all come in interesting and intricate shapes.
Like all Unidragon's puzzles, the big part of the fun here is how they have worked in thematic shapes into the puzzle. While putting together this puzzle, you'll find pieces in all sorts of shapes of spaceships, telescopes, ray guns, aliens, robots, and more.
Now, once the puzzle's built, the next step is to grab the logbook again and use it to explore each of the four quadrants of the puzzle. Now, you can do these in any order, which is a nice bit of exploration. Now, the quests in each quadrant have you looking for things across the entire puzzle. For example, in the Happy Republic, we had to collect pieces of a prototype which consisted of three lab crates and a number of vials.
As you spot these items, you actually pull them out of the puzzle. Once you've collected a complete set, you combine the pieces to form a mini puzzle. Each completed mini puzzle gives you a clue you'll need to solve the overall game.
Now, in addition, each quadrant's quest ends with a simple mini game. These include things like tic-tac-toe, odds and evens, building then rolling dice to see who rolls higher, and a shooting game that uses those 3D ships you built earlier.
And I can't help but noticing that this game is the opposite of Voltron. Rather than five yes. little mini puzzles combining to create one, you've got one giant puzzle decombining to create five mini puzzles.
Yes, it is.
Once you collect the clues from all four factions, You'll be able to open up the cryptex. That will lead you to the next step.
We don't want to spoil the fun. So I think we're going to stop right there and let you discover the end of Quezzle Space Adventures on your own.
So early we noted that this is actually a follow-up to Quezzle Amazing Cappadocia, which we reviewed in 2022, and I think it's worth taking a bit of time to compare these two quest puzzles.
All right, so the first big difference is this is one box. This is a single box, one big 1,000-piece puzzle, as opposed to four separate 250-piece puzzles. What this also means is there's just one thing to buy instead of the weird model where you bought box one and then you were encouraged to buy the other boxes. All that mess is gone. You buy this, you get the whole thing at once.
Now, being one big puzzle, that does mean that the puzzle part of Quezzle Space Adventures was much more difficult than any of the individual Quezzle Amazing Cappadocia boxes.
Now, the other big change here is in regards to clarity. The entire game aspect of Amazing Cappadocia was not really clear. I know multiple people who thought they had discovered all the game had to offer, only to read our review and find out we were missing out on half the game. Space Adventures doesn't have that problem. What you need to do, when to do it, and in what order is very clear and all tracked right in that logbook.
Now, we might even go so far as to say too clear. You are handheld through every step of the adventure here. While this is better than getting completely stumped or lost, that comes at the expense of the sense of discovery and exploration that comes from discovering things on your own.
And then another part of this is because this new version does not have or require an app. Now, there is one part of the game where you do have to scan a QR code in order to get one of the clues, but it just directs you to a web page on Unidragon's, a page on Unidragon's website. Though do note, you will need some form of internet access to complete the quest, as that QR code does lead to a vital clue, but that can come from any mobile device, or you can even just do it on your PC.
So they also dropped the whole AR element. It barely worked and was never fully completed in Amazing Cappadocia, and I think this was a good choice. They had overstretched and realized they had and just pulled back from that.
Yeah, totally agree on that one. Now, one new thing you're going to find here is that it has a hint system. This is greatly appreciated. Well, the hint system in Space Adventures is really just a line drawing of the map with some color-coded sections to tell you where to look for stuff. It really is all that's needed because the logbook walks you through everything else. Now, the other thing you're going to find more of here are game elements. Now, there are little things like mazes on the map, and there's find and seek quests. But there's also arcade-style shooting ships and very basic tabletop games. This is quite the contrast to the very escape room in a box-style experience that was in Amazing Cappadocia.
Now, while you do get more games here, the games are very simple. You are looking at things like tic-tac-toe and rolling dice to see who rolls higher.
I think this is actually the most important thing to know about Quezzle Space Adventures for the regular tabletop bellhop audience of hobby board gamers. The game elements in this mashup of puzzle and game are incredibly simple and basic. Like, we're talking grade school level schoolyard games here. Now, I will say I was at least impressed by the number of games. I was like, man, they put in way more. I like the fact that there's more game to this than the original. I can't say the same for the rest of my family. They were very disappointed and wanted something with some meat on it. I want to say more meat, but I don't even think there was meat there. They were especially disappointed. Like, we could tell you're going to make these awesome dice and you literally, you roll a die, I roll a die, who rolls higher wins. Like, come on, that's a game. And while odds and evens, which is the whole thing where you're like, you hold a bunch of stones and you hold out so many stones, your opponent says odds or evens. And if you're right, you take the stones from them. And if you're wrong, they get the stones. And whoever has the most stones at the end wins. Like, these are barely games.
Yeah, it's interesting how much they changed it up. But the choice of games in changing that up just becomes questionable. If you're going to attempt a puzzle of this difficulty, as we pointed out, it's a 1,000-piece puzzle, you don't expect preschool-level games.
But I'm a hobby gamer, and I'm holding what a puzzle game that might... It is literally more accessible and family friendly than the first. While the folks in my family all play a lot of games together and we wanted something more, I have a feeling this is going to actually be more appealing to your average family who just loves doing jigsaw puzzles together. And I think people are going to appreciate the quick and easy to play games.
I don't know. They've clearly learned a lot from their crowdfunding experiences. I think the dropping of AR was a big sort of note that they got from that first Amazing CAPPADOCIA experience. But I'm not sure they learned all the right lessons. Either that, or they are simply casting their net too wide for an audience and are risking satisfying none of them. For example, my family isn't the level of gaming your family is. And I would have a hard time believing that my kids would want to play tic-tac-toe or just roll to see who's higher, as part of a game to solve a significant puzzle.
Yeah, and to be fair, too, none of that's needed. Like, they threw in these games, but the games don't do anything. You, like, finish a chapter, and then, like, now you sit down with the alien who you just helped, and he introduces you to his favorite game, tic-tac-toe. Like, there's no reason to play the games. Like, an actual quote from one of my kids was, no, I won't play that. We don't have to, right? Let's just skip it. Like, let's just move on to the next part of the puzzle. And I'm the mean dad that made the kids play tic-tac-toe and roll the dice because I'm like, I want the full Quezzle experience. We're going to play these stupid games. Now, with those games being so simplified, and Sean already mentioned this, that what's not simple is the puzzle. The puzzle is 1,000 pieces. It's not a small puzzle. And they were, it's evil. There are a lot of straight edges in this puzzle that have nothing to do with the edges of the puzzle. And I've got to say that the most enjoyable part of this was putting the puzzle together. The actual jigsaw puzzle part of Quezzle Space Adventures. It took us 3 days to get it done. Like, and that was split up. Like, I don't know the number of hours, but like, we set it up at night. The kids had a hard time getting him to bed. Gwen woke up at like 6:30 on the morning before anyone else in the entire house to go downstairs to the living room to work on the Quezzle and on the puzzle. And like, we worked on it throughout that day and we did other things. You know, we went downtown, we did some stuff, come back to my uncle's place and worked on the Quezzle for a bit more. Like, it was spread out, but it took us 3 days to beat.
And that is a stark contrast to the rest of these game five portions.
Now, I gotta say, one of the best parts of the puzzle experience, though, isn't necessarily just getting the right piece in the right place, right? Though it's discovering the artwork here is fantastic. It's that very busy style with lots going on and kind of little stories, right? Like discovering stories in the graphics. Like I mentioned, sitting down with the alien to play tic-tac-toe. Well, in the story, it talks about where that happens. Well, that spot's on the map and you can see the two aliens that were arguing on the map. And my kids liked coming up with theories on what individual pieces were and what different pieces of artwork meant. And because like all Unidragon puzzles, you find unique shapes that have nothing to do with the puzzle. So there's the space dog, you know, the dog with the big space hat was in there. And there were even some like two-part ones. The dog, you found his head, and then later we found his legs. Well, that wasn't part of any of the mini puzzles. That wasn't anything else. That was just something interesting to discover while building the puzzle. And there were satellites and spaceships, and then there was some weird two multi-part alien. And man, we kept just finding all these tentacles and we made a pile of tentacles eventually and the tentacles formed something. Like, that's the stuff that's really neat about all of Unidragon's puzzles. And it was just as present here as it is in their others.
Yeah. And that's reassuring that while they have learned lessons and they have made changes from the Amazing CAPPADOCIA, what hasn't changed is that core puzzler's game within the Unidragon puzzles, which is really what you expect from a Unidragon puzzle is that amazing and intricate puzzle and the bizarre and intriguing pieces that they use. Mm-hmm.
Now, we also had a lot of fun with the mini puzzles. There's no spoiler here, right? I didn't call this a spoiler here review. It's very obvious. You go on the Kickstarter page, Unidragon's talking about it. You know you're going to get mini puzzles. Though I got to say, Deanna and I let the kids handle the find and seek part. While the artwork is nice and bright, clear, the details are very small. And the things you're looking for are even tinier. So I will say, as two adults with aging eyes, that part of the puzzle was probably left to younger generations.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. Unidragon makes great puzzles. That's what they do. Yep. They are drifting and trying to find something new and inventive within Quezzle, and they've gone in two sort of different directions now. It'll be interesting to see what happens if and when we see a a Quezzle Volume 3.
Yeah, I totally agree. And I will say there is a third part coming. You get some hints towards that. As for the quest part of this one, it was enjoyable. It was fun. Like discovering each piece of the code was neat. The cryptex is cool. That was one aspect. As soon as I found it, I'm like, oh, this is reminding me of some of the wooden puzzle boxes I've done, right? You get this cool, it looks like Saturn, and you got dials on it, and there's letters on it, and you're like, oh, I'm going to have to figure, I think it was numbers, you're going to have to figure out how to open this. And then when we opened it, it was just like a really cool, because it wasn't like a you win, it was just another hint. And it was one of those where you pulled the hint out, and we're like, oh, I know exactly what that means. We're going to have to do this. And this is the part I'm not going to spoil. Now, you don't quite get the escape room in a box style series of clues that you got in Amazing Cappadocia. But what they did put in this is really good. Now, I will say the majority of it, though, is hide and seek, right? You're trying to find things. But there were just those little bits, even just opening the box. The whole you had to turn the dials to the right spot to open the box was a nice touch.
Yeah, no, I think they have really advanced a long way from some of the mistakes in Amazing Cappadocia. And while I think they, you know, could have conceivably made a couple of smaller missteps here, again, the core of Unidragon is the puzzle. And with that comes the which way, not which way, but yeah, where's Waldo concept sort of things that they do so well. And we're not missing out on that here.
No, not at all. And I think there's more in this than the last one, though I didn't count the number of pieces you had to find. The other thing I will say is we use the hint page, and props to Unidragon for including it. This was one of those, like, I let the kids look at things, and you just, you know, read the kids' body language when it seemed like they're kind of sick of looking for things. We'd be like, I kind of cheated. Like, here's Dad sitting back with the hints going, I think there's one over in the Happy Kingdom over there. There's one by the, remember the big purple dinosaur? Yes, there's dinosaurs. You might want to look over there. And what I liked about that is we used it pretty liberally, pretty quickly, which just removed any frustration. The only frustration, though, that we did have, and this has to be called out, I think, is building those 3D ships at the beginning. The laser cut wood is very expertly cut in all these puzzles. Like, the pieces just fit. Like, if your piece is on a bit of a bend, it's not going to slide in. It's got to be perfectly flat. And we've all developed our own little system for tapping on them to get them to fall in, right? Well, the ships are also like that, but you have to assemble these. And there's, like, zero tolerance on these. And everything just fits. Now, what this means is no glues required, which is awesome. Like, I love the fact that I love the fact that I did not require glue to build these ships. But it also meant I was the only one that could get the ships together. And I would have liked to have had some kind of mallet there. A rubber mallet would have been very useful for assembling some of these ships.
Yeah, I think the range of ages you had participating in this helped. You had grown-ups. You had, the young teens. The only thing that might have maybe helped even more is having some even younger kids there who might have actually enjoyed playing tic-tac-toe and dice.
That's true. Overall, building and solving Quezzle Space Adventures was a great family experience. It became a fun part of a family vacation we took. It's one I hope the kids will fondly remember for years to come. And I have a strong feeling that before we go up next year, we're going to have to find some type of puzzle to bring, because I think that's going to be part of the experience when we travel up north. Despite being a family of hobby board gamers who all wish the game that were built into Adventures were a little less simplistic, maybe a lot less simplistic. Overall, we had a great time.
Now, if you or your friends enjoy jigsaw puzzles, you should pick up a copy of Quezzle Volume 2 Space Adventures. It's a fantastic jigsaw puzzle that also presents you with some simple games to play, a fun Waldo-style quest system, and some other unique puzzle elements.
Now, I also think this is going to be a good game to pick up for kids, for your kids, or to have for the neighbors to come over. Or even if you happen to be an educator, this could be a good classroom game. I'm going probably as far back. I don't know if kindergarten's safe. There might be swallowable bits in there would be a problem. But I think it'd be a good game to have that. This Quezzle is much more approachable than the last one. And it does a great job of leading you through each part of the game step by step. While the tabletop games included were too light for us, I think they're perfect for younger kids. As Sean mentioned, kids who enjoy tic-tac-toe still. Just make sure you have an adult on hand to help with building those spaceships.
Well, for a look at a challenging puzzle-solving experience, or a murder mystery, or an escape room in a box-style experience, you're going to want to look elsewhere. Quezzle isn't going to scratch that itch for you. Maybe check out Body of Evidence, Best Served Cold, or La Famiglia, which we've both reviewed, for something more to your tastes.
Now, personally, what impressed me the most about this combination of puzzle and game is the progression that was made between Quezzle Amazing Cappadocia to Quezzle Space Adventures. This is a much more polished and approachable product. Unlike our last Quezzle review, I didn't feel the need to spoil part of the puzzles to make sure people are getting the most out of their game. I still get emails almost every week asking for help with solving the original. I don't think that's going to happen with the sequel. I think Unidragon learned a lot from the first game, and I am really looking forward to what they offer up next. I can only assume it's going to continue to get better, and as I noted earlier, we do know another one's coming, as when you finish Quezzle Space Adventures, you get a strong hint at what the theme of the next Quezzle will be.
We're not going to spoil it, though. You'll have to solve Space Adventures yourself to discover what's next.
Now, if you do decide to pick up Quezzle Space Adventures, if we sold it to you tonight, it will be available at unidragon.com as of September 15th. And when you go there, be sure to use our code BELLHOP to save 10% off.
That's it for our review of Quezzle Volume 2 Space Adventures, a new mashup of Puzzle and Jigsaw with a lot more game in the box than the last puzzle. Though those games are way simpler than we would have hoped, what do you think would have been a better choice? What kind of small, quick games would you like to see in a mashup of puzzle and game like Quezzle?
Now, for a more detailed look at this new Quezzle, be sure to stop by the blog, tabletopbellhop.com. Check out my written review. It's live right now. Also, if you enjoyed this review and the other content we produce, please consider tipping your bellhop at patreon.com/tabletopbellhop.